Hey everyone, it's Nick Valenti with NJ Valenti Art, and in today's video, I want to go over what's new in Affinity Designer's 2.3 update. Let's take a look. So I'm going to focus on Affinity Designer specifically, but these updates affect all three of their programs, Photo, Designer, and Publisher. But again, we'll focus on Designer aspects for right now. One of the features I'm most excited about is the Spiral tool, and you can find that in the Shapes feature, the drop-down menu right down here. We'll click and hold that, and the Spiral tool will be right here at the bottom. So we'll go ahead and we'll come up here, and if you just click and drag, you'll see it creates a spiral. We'll zoom in here, we're gonna up the stroke so we can see it a little bit better. All right, so with the spiral tool selected, you just click and drag, and you get yourself a spiral. Now there are plenty of options that we could play around with if you come right up here to the context toolbar. Starting off, we have our styles. So first one being linear. We can also choose decaying, semicircular, counter semicircular, Fibonacci, and plotted. And by selecting any of these, we have additional options over here. We can reverse the spiral. We can cause segments in the spiral. Okay. We can also affect how many turns we have, how much. Got the angles, we get some cool weird looking effects that way as well, and then an inner radius as well. So there's quite a few different options that we could play around with each of these. So even if we were to go ahead and turn this over here to the segments and up the segment numbers here, see, we'll get more of those lines there. Okay, so tons of different things that we could play around with here. We can add more. And we have all of our same options here. Okay, we can even add more divisions to, or more segments. So once again, a lot of very cool features we get to use. This one doesn't really affect that too much. Here we got a few points there. But pretty cool tool. I could see this being very useful for a lot of different illustration assets and whatnot. So first on the list, the spiral tool. The next feature is the pixel grid option. Now, if we were to come up here to view and click on show pixel grid, as we zoom into this document, it's based on the resolution. So as we zoom into the document, once it crosses that threshold, we will see the pixel grid right here, pick up. What you can also use this for, though, is I've created a document over here. It's a 64 by 64 pixel document. I'm going to come back up here and I'm going to click on show pixel grid. Now this will give me the 64 by 64. So this is really great, especially if you want to focus on doing pixel art, whether it's for game development or it's just this particular style that you like to work in. By switching over to the pixel persona up top here, we can then select our pixel tool, and then we can just start our pixel drawing. So the next feature I'd like to go over is the move data entry feature. This has been in Affinity since, I believe, 2.2, but they've added, you can now add the items behind the objects instead of just the front. So what we'll go ahead and do is we'll select all these objects, we'll press enter or return, and we get this move duplicate options menu now. So we can come down here and click on duplicate. This will give us our option for the number of copies we would like. And new to 2.3 is the insertion mode. You could choose whether or not you want the objects to appear in front of these or behind them. We'll select behind for now. And then we have all these different options that we could play with in the meantime. So if we come up here to horizontal, this will move those copies. So we have 15 copies that are now moving horizontally behind our original circles. You can control vertical as well. The distance from the originals. We have an angle. Could also change the rotation. And the scale. So you can have each circle get progressively smaller. So say we did 90 there. Okay, and then we could again play with the rotation a little bit. So just a lot of different things that you could play around with. Test some things out on and come up with some pretty cool looking results. So I'm going to kind of just go over some of the other features that are part of the update. Some of them I don't use as much in Affinity Designer for the vector art that I do. If you would like to see any of these explained a little bit more, let me know in the comments. I'll go ahead and make a video on it. But you'll see here at the top, we've got the spiral tool, which we went over, the pixel grid option as well. You can also now create and place password protected PDFs, which is a neat feature and can be very useful. We have the move data entry improvements tags panel. This is specific to publisher. It's not a program that I use too much. Change asset panel background color. This gives you the option of changing the background from a light or dark UI setting to even the transparent pixel background there. Fields find and replace. This is again another publisher update. Not specific to publisher, and keep selected preference in pencil tool for Affinity Designer. This will allow you to keep the options selected there. So pretty cool, nothing too crazy, but definitely some neat little features to play around with. Definitely very cool. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. Let me know what you think of Affinity Designer's 2.3 update down in the comments. Please like, subscribe, and hit the bell so you don't miss any new videos. You can support the channel directly by clicking the Super Thanks button directly below the video. Thank you so much, and until next time.